Hello. So I decided for the render part of it, I should just do a voiceover because I figure it's gonna be easy to talk through it. I just don't wanna be make a video without telling you the major things that I did. So I wouldn't be doing this tutorial the exact thing. I would be doing the exact thing, but I wouldn't be doing the entire tutorial because it's probably gonna take longer. Longer because it takes longer to render, but I will just show you the major things I did to get the render quality you see in the thumbnail. So to start, the first thing we're going to do is upload our file into Visualize. So we're gonna just select that coffee mug assembly we made in SolidWorks, and we just drag it to the Visualize screen. And so once it loads up, and if you notice in the assembly, I had a split face on the coffee mug and the salsa. I had that the split face just to be able to control the material when I bring it into SolidWorks Visualize. So the next thing I want to make sure is that my geometry and appearance is checked. I want to be able to monitor file just in case if I want to reload it the next time. And I want this to set to automatic, and I'm just going to click OK. And now our file has been added. And the next the so now we can see that if I click on each material, I can select them individually. And that was why I had the split face on it, just to be able to control the material in SolidWorks Visualize. So essentially, this yellow is gonna be the same as this, so we can probably just combine these two material by right-clicking on this, selecting copy, and come into this, right clicking, and do assign color. So now when I click on this, everything is one material. So that's good. So we have this material, this is a different material, this is gonna be our coffee. And the salsa has like a yellow plate, so all our material seems to be good. So we're just gonna go real quick through this. So for the coffee mug, we're just gonna select the snap to floor, make sure everything is snap to floor. I usually just come down to preview, enable floor shadow, maybe reflect other model, and that would be it. That's what I did. And so the next thing is our material, but to show you what I did from the material, because I said I don't want to do the entire thing again. Not that I don't want to do it again to show you, but I figure I'll just give you the tips of what I did, and you can walk through it to just be use it to create your own coffee mug the way you want to create it. So I'm just gonna upload the next finished one, and I'm gonna pause this video and upload the finished one that I made, and I'm just gonna show you the key things I did to it to get the render quality that I have in the thumbnail. So I'll pause this video and resume shortly. Hello guys, so I'm back. I just uploaded the finished one that I made, so I just want to show you the key things I did. So under my appearance, like I said, I made all the yellow one on just one material, so which is this one. So I have it as generic, and I just pretty much did the color I want. And for the specular color, I just make it what I want. So all this is gonna be according to your own preference, and feel free to go be creative with it and just adjust it to whatever you see in it. And so for all this, I left it at black, and for my values, roughness, 0, and internal roughness, I had that, and on IOR value, I have 3. So I adjusted. It took me a while to adjust it, but I found that these are the values that work pretty well for me. So the next material I want to go to is the white color for the coffee mug and the saucer. So for that one, I did paint material just to be able to control the clear coat, just to allow that reflection. And I did just straight white. And for the clear coat roughness, I just did 0.18. So that was all I did for that. And next, we are going to let's do this brown thing you see. They are coffee beans. I will show you exactly how I did that. Just a quick tip. So I have my coffee bean. If you notice in the assembly, we add two different material to the face of the coffee bean, to the front and the back. That's just so that way we'll be able to control it when we add our mapping material. So what I did is I found a picture on Google. If I go back to my desktop, so I found this picture on Google, and I just Google paint coffee bean. I found this picture. So what I did is, so from this picture, you want to, what I did is I deleted the background, so I just have that peanut and I saved the picture as a PNG file. And the next thing I did is I also used Photoshop to generate the bump map. So I can show you just real quick how I did it. So this is, so if I go to Photoshop, I'll just go back to that file and I just drag it to Photoshop, and that comes up. And I'm not a professional at Photoshop, so please bear with me. I just know how to use different things to try to get what I want. So I press Control, I think it's Control plus just to zoom in. So then the next thing I want to select is the quick selection tool. I found that works better for this one. So I'll just click on it and drag this edge all the way to the end, just to until it snaps to the end. I'm just gonna do it real quick because I don't want to take too much of your time. Drag on it real quick. So once I have everything selected, I then the next thing I did is I think is Control Shift I. Yes. I was watching a tutorial on YouTube to learn how to just extract the picture from and delete the background from a picture. So Control Shift I, what that does is it selects the background. So as you can see the matching ant around it, and that's what I want. So I just press the backspace to delete it, and I click OK. So now my background has been deleted. And what I did is I just do File, Save As, browse down to PNG file, and you save it as whatever you want, and you click OK. I mean, you click Save. So that's so I did none fast, and okay. So the next thing I did is let's just deselect this once we save the PNG file. The next thing I did is and this is a little bit jagged, but I'm just showing you what I did real quick. You might have to mess with it a little bit more just to get what you want. So the next thing I did is convert this picture to just to get the bump map. So I also watched another tutorial on YouTube, and the way it was done, and I find it works helps works in my case is you go to Image and you go to Mode and you select Grayscale, discard. So it changes it to that. Then the next thing you do again, you go to Image, Adjustment, and you want to select Invert. So it turns flips it back, because for the bump map we're gonna be using in our bump a bump selection in SolidWorks Visualize, you want you can either use the purple color normal map or the grayscale. The grayscale works too. So once you do that, then the next thing you do is you do you go back to image again, adjustments, and you want to do brightness and contrast, and I just drag this to 80, works better, and I clicked OK. So that's pretty much what I did, and I also saved it as a PNG file. So I just do file save as PNG, name it as a bump. So once that's done, and so let's, when I go back to SolidWorks Visualize, so on the the color, that's where you would add your diffuse. So when I add my diffuse, you want to make sure that your texture mapping is so if I select that, and now let me select, so I need to select the face that was added to that texture mapping. You want to have it on planar, so you just adjust everything to see if it, to adjust it, you'll click on this object manipulation over here. So this is the move to, this is the scale to. You probably be using the scale more often in this one. So, and that's how I pretty much did the coffee beans. So the next thing, so I did that for the one I just showed you on Photoshop, that is the front of the coffee bean. You also need the back. So you pretty much look for a picture of a back of a coffee bean, and you would repeat that entire that same process. So the next thing we're gonna do is for our coffee, on our coffee mug. So if I click on my material, and I'll just go up, let me just click on my color and not enable it, and I'll click on my bump, and I'll also disable it too. You'll see that this is the material we made in SolidWorks. If you know that, the surface we revolved. So what we just needed for is to put our mapping on it, just to try to just to make our coffee. So I'll enable back my coffee. So what I did for the coffee is just regular paint, no clear coat, a little bit roughness, almost white. So for the same thing, I found the picture on Google. It is this picture. So what I did is the same thing I did with the coffee bean. You will put it in Photoshop or whatever software you have to extract this coffee from it. But this is all you need. And so, and you would do the same thing. You try to get the diffuse map and the bump map. So when you are done, you should have something like this. So I made this, I just dragged it over from my other screen. So you should have something like this. Then you will save it as the diffuse, and you also save it as the bump map. So once that's done, you come into Visualize, you make your material. Under the material, you just pretty much add your diffuse to the color and add your bump. So for my diffuse, those are the values I have. Nothing too major. I think these are pretty much the standard values that came with it. I just probably adjusted my brightness to 3. Then for the bump, I have 5, inverted it. Pretty much not too, I didn't do too much tricky stuff with it. And for my mood, I had to set it as planar, because you projecting it on a flat surface, so you need to have it as planar. So once that's done, I'm gonna click this enable texture. So once that's done, I'm on fast mode now, that's why my coffee looks like that. So I go into my scene. For my scene, I found that it's best to use HDR Light Studio. It works perfectly. With using just the regular HDR that comes with Visualize. They work too, but if you want to control the light the way you want to affect different parts in your scene, then I found that HDR Light Studio works for it. So I have it installed. So I just pretty much set my lights how I want, and once I got the what I was looking for, and I saved it. So that's pretty much all I did in the scene. And for the camera, you pretty much just rotate it to whatever view you want, and everything is pretty much standard. And for my post-processing, that's the those are the values I have. And don't worry, feel free to ask me for all these files, and I will be more than happy to send it to you, so that way you just have everything to follow along when you work on it. So these are the values I have for my post-processing. And so now when I go to fast mode, and you can see everything, in my opinion, came the way I wanted to. Or even if I go to the accurate mode, either one works. And when I just let it rest up, and you see everything starting to come together. So that's the basics of what I did for this project, just to get the rendering modeling in SolidWorks and render in SolidWorks Visualize. Thanks guys for watching, and I would, in the future, I would be adding all these files to the description, so that way you can download it and just follow along. But for right now, I actually don't know where to upload the file where you can copy the link. I mean, click the link to download it. But once I figure that out, I'm going to be adding the link to the description box. So thanks for watching, and I hope you find it creative. And if there is any other way this could be done to improve, please feel free to share your own ideas. I'll be more than happy to learn from you guys. So thank you, and this is how I made the coffee mug with the coffee in it and the coffee beans on the plate. Thank you, and have a nice day. Bye.